Picture this. You are an alien, and you're making your journey across space when you come across a planet you've never seen before, planet Earth. A car catches your eye. You want to understand how it works and bring this amazing technology back to your home planet. You don't know how this car works, so you start removing things one by one from the car to see what happens. First, you remove the hood and see that the car will start, so you know it must not be involved in starting the car. Next thing you remove is the wheel, and you see that the car can no longer turn or move without the wheel, so you know it must somehow be involved in its motion. Finally, you remove the door handle, and the car still functions just fine without the door handle, so you know that it is not critical for driving the car. Each time you remove something, you get a clue about what it might do. This is one strategy scientists use to learn what different genes do. Each gene is a set of instructions for making a protein with a specific job, like the instructions for making a door handle in our car example. By completely removing that protein from an animal or a cell, you can see what changes and make a guess about that protein's job. But how do scientists do this? We don't actually need to remove the entire gene. Using molecular tools, we can insert a line in the genetic instructions that says, "Stop making this protein." The functional protein is never made, and we can now look for clues about what its job might have been. This technique is called a gene knockout.